Hey guys, good evening and thanks for joining. So apologies for delay for 3 minutes. Yeah, so morning we have started a phishing email investigation. And also we discussed about ransomware investigation. And also a couple of people are already replied back. I think Kranti, Srividya, Amar, or Akhil. Sorry, Akhil. So I will validate and update you by tomorrow. Okay. Whoever sent it to me, respect to incident investigation related to ransomware server got compromised. So we will continue phishing email investigation. So morning, as we discussed, so what is phishing email and what are the different types of phishing email we have? How can we identify phishing email? Okay, so how can you do phishing email investigation? And so what are the different types of scenarios we can discuss now? So just now one of the candidate called me. He attended, I think, Trianz interview, T-R-I-A-N-Z. It's one of the company. So in the interview point of view, they asked about phishing email investigation only. So whatever we discussed in the class morning, same thing they asked in the interview point of view also. Where can we see header analyzer in the outlook? Okay. One of the, or maybe one of the email is received as spear phishing, 10 members. Out of 10 members, two people are clicked on. In that scenario, what will you do analysis part? Okay, first thing is what actions you will do. So how can you identify the header analyzer in the Outlook Office 365? Where can we identify?
Down arrow?
Yes. So it's we have to open... Yeah, everyone is correct. So we have to open the email. In that email, middle of the email, we have one of the arrow mark is there. That arrow mark name is called message options. If you are clicking on that message options, we can see the entire header analyzer, starting with email address, IP address, sender email address, recipient email address. So everything in the HTML format. Okay. So now we can discuss about scenarios. So how normally in the entry point of view, they will ask. So first scenario is malicious URL link as a spear phishing sent it by an attacker to 10 end users. How can you do investigation? Okay. Anybody can explain this scenario? So we'll discuss later. One second, guys. What happened? Second one, phishing email attacker sent an email to 10 users with attaching of malware. How can you do investigation? Under phishing email attackers, sent in 100 phishing emails to different users. How can you prioritize the phishing email investigation? And also, how can you handle the situation? So this is the way they will ask practically, guys. So generally, fourth one is malicious URL link investigation. Obviously, malicious malware attachment investigation. So last one is normal phishing email investigation. So these are all the couple of scenarios. So first we can go and we can see malicious URL. These three we can discuss later. First one, two, three. First we can discuss this one. Normal phishing email investigation, what will you do? Normal phishing investigation, what will you do? Anyone? One of the phishing email you received to single user, what will you do? Without any attachment, without any malicious URL link.
Well, with the domain.
Domain validation. Yeah.
IP address validation.
IP address validation.
Header.
Next
analysis.
One? Yes. Header analysis. So these three. So without any URL link, without any, okay, so malware attachment. It's to single user only. To single user. Okay. So next one, that is one of the scenario. So after doing all these analysis, finally we can conclude that whether it is a phishing email or not. And finally, what is the end user has done? Okay. He responded back and so on. So next one is malicious URL link validation or malicious URL link to single user. So in this scenario, what will you do?
The same.
Take URLs, put in MX tool.
First three, yes. And then along with that, we have to validate the URL link, whether it's malicious.
Exactly. That's correct. URL link validation also. Okay. After validating URL link. So just URL link you will validate, or will you do any other additional analysis? Will you go and validate just only URL link, or other than that, will you validate any other analysis?
Is that link is clicked by user or not?
How can you check that whether end user is clicked on or not? How can you, you are right. Whatever you are saying, absolutely right. How can you see whether end user is clicked or not? Where you can validate?
Yeah.
So you are right. Yeah, this, yeah. Give me 1 second. MX tool or virustotal.com. Here also MX tool or virustotal.com. Head analyzer, which tool? MX tool.
MX tool.
Yeah. URL link validation, URL scan, or
virustotal.com
or hybridanalysis.com. Okay, you have done normal analysis now. So based on this one, will you conclude whether it's a phishing email or not?
FTP server, is that user clicked on this email link or not?
Yeah, based on this analysis, we can say it's a phishing email or not. You are right. From there, okay, so false positive you concluded. Maybe true positive concluded. Whether it is got compromised or not, how can you validate? Which logs you will analyze? Which tool you will analyze?
Email gateway.
SMTP server.
No, SMTP server redirection will not show. URL link redirection will show SMTP server. No. Which tool we have to see?
Proxy server.
Excellent. Yes. Proxy server. Proxy, URL. Proxy or one more tool name is?
Firewall.
Excellent, firewall. Proxy or firewall, guys. URL. So URL, which one? Obviously, even EDR also possibility is there. First one, priority is proxy number one. Okay. So whether end user is clicked or not. So we can go and we can check in the proxy traffic or next generation firewall traffic or EDR also. So what exactly proxy traffic will show? So what is the action we can see here, proxy or next generation firewall or EDR? For example, action is showing as it's a block. What you can conclude from this one?
False.
He did not click it. Yeah, exactly. So he clicked on, but unfortunately, our tools are blocked that activity. So end user is clicked on, but fortunately, because of signature-based detection mechanism, because of the behavioral pattern mechanism, So this tool is provided, it's a malicious content and automatically it is blocked. Nothing but it's not got compromised. Now, for suppose action is showing as redirected or allowed or yeah, so these are the couple of things. Okay, in that scenario,
true positive.
Yes, true positive now. True positive now. So whether we have to go and we have to see, is there any outbound connections went on from this particular end user system? So obviously single user meaning here, that user IP address will be there. So example 10.10.10.1. So now from 10.10.10.1, we have to copy that particular IP address of the end user. Okay, so in this scenario, we have to go and we have to see. So what is the command and control related outbound connections went on? Redirected connections went on, allowed connections went on. So whatever allowed IP address is there, that IP we have to take and we have to validate. So is there any data breach has happened? And also, first of all, that particular IP address is belongs to legitimate or illegitimate or malicious or abnormal or suspicious. Okay, so just we can take the particular IP address, go to the firewall under the which tab we have to go now, firewall, to see whether end user is clicked or not. Which tab we have to go? So example proxy traffic or next generation firewall traffic or EDR, which tab we have to go, whatever action is showing as a redirector or allowed? Which tab? Firewall, which tab we have to go and we have to see?
Logs and?
You are right. Log and?
Report.
Yes, excellent. Log and report tab, guys. Log and report tab or forwarded traffic tab. Under log and report tab, we have forwarded traffic is there. So we have to go to forwarded traffic option. And we have to filter out which IP now? 10.10.10.1. Okay, is there? What are the connections it has happened? So which connections it went outside from this 10.10.10.1? Okay. Finally, we have to change the password also. First thing is, whatever system it is getting compromised, first thing is we have to change the password. Which password we have to change? Which password we have to change?
DNS.
For the actions or mitigations, we have to change. Actions or mitigations. DNS, are you sure? Email.
Yeah, email password.
Yes, Outlook or email server password. Why? Because from his email, maybe he will send it to other persons of the internal employees. Okay, from his email address, after changing the password, so maybe he'll send it to a couple of other phishing email URL links. Now, what other employees will think? He's from our user only, our organization only. So he needs some of the information. They will think like he is a colleague. On behalf of the now end user, attacker will send the emails to other colleagues in the organization level. What everybody will think? Okay, it's a genuine email. Okay. First thing is we have to change Outlook or email password, or maybe even you have to change the Windows password also. Okay. After that, which thing we have to analyze? Additionally, one more thing we have to analyze, which one? In this scenario, will you do containment or not, first of all? In this scenario, we have to do, yeah. So we have to do containment as well. It's a true positive and it's got compromised. So containment we have to do, and after that eradication mitigation. Then what additional things you will validate? What additional things will you validate? Don't you go and block that URL link in proxy or firewall? Okay, so block the malicious URL link in the proxy or firewall. Whatever URL link, initially it came via email attachment or email. So we have to block that IP, URL link in the proxy or firewall. Additionally,
block the IP.
What additional information you will validate in the recovery phase?
Hash value.
Why? It is not malware attachment. It's not file, right? URL link only.
All firewall logs and everything.
In the recovery phase, from the end user mission, any data will lost it.
Exactly. Data lost is happened or not. Is there any data copied by attacker? So DLP logs, we have to validate. Is there any data loss is happened? So you have done everything now. So what else you will do? Summary of the report and root cause analysis document. Incident. So if you are doing the root cause analysis document and all summary of the report, why it will be useful for future purpose? Which time value it will reduce?
Meantime to detect, meantime to identify,
meantime to recovery. MTTD, MTTR, MTTI. So that is the reason we have to create RCA. This RCA document is like a future reference document or maybe knowledge base. So if you are creating this RCA document, it's like a lessons learned. So this lessons learned document can be used to reduce the MTTR, MTTI, mean time to detection, mean time to identification, mean time to recovery. Okay, so in future, similar type of incident we received, it will reduce the instant investigation or forensic investigation time. Maybe today it is taking first time we received this particular incident. Okay, first time we received the particular incident. Maybe today it is taking 4 hours. So tomorrow, once again, same incident it is receiving. Already we have reference document is there, knowledge base is there, lessons learned document is there. We'll follow that particular document, what exactly we have done for the previous analysis or instant investigation analysis. We'll follow those steps. Finally, instead of taking the 1 hour time, now it will take only 45 minutes. So nothing but meantime to identification, detection, and recovery also, it will take less time. So all these things also you have to say in the entry point of view. MTTD, MTTR, MTTI. Okay, so these are all technical words. So that is about one of the scenario. Now third scenario. Malicious malware attachment. Single user. Okay, in this scenario. Single user or group of users, anything is fine. What will you do? What will you do in this scenario?
How do we say all the four?
Okay, all the four? All three? Okay. Yes. Additionally?
Hash value.
Okay, hash value, malware analysis. So we'll take the file or we'll take the hash value. Okay, then we'll go and we'll check the, what is the hash value? So if it is already EDR tool is blocking, that is like a false positive. If EDR or next generation firewall is allowing, that means once the user is clicked on, endo system is got compromised. Okay, nothing but, so action is allowed. So next steps, what will you do? Same thing here also.
If it is blocked, then same, sir.
Yeah. So same thing, we have to go and we have to validate all these. So whether end user is clicked on, clicked in means downloaded here, not clicked on, downloaded. Downloaded the attachment. So here now, which tool we can go and we can see? First one is EDR tool. EDR tool. Next one, next generation firewall. So if it is action is block, whenever the end user is clicked on the attachments or downloading the attachment, EDR is already blocked. What is the conclusion from this one?
False positive.
Yeah. So if, for suppose it is allowed. Here also allowed. In that scenario?
True positive.
What thing you will take care?
Contaminate first.
Containment, yes. Containment of end user machine.
Delete the file from the system.
Okay.
Rerun the antivirus scans.
OS. Okay.
Current.
Next one.
And then the last one. DL.
Change it. Yeah, change the password. What else? One more thing you are not saying, very important thing.
File integrity monitoring logs check.
No.
We'll connect the Windows team and first check with the new system and come back.
Other than that, one more thing. We have to block something. What is that?
Hash value.
Hash value blocking in the which tool?
Virus total.
Sorry. EDR tool. Okay. So now after that root cause analysis document. Okay. So then we have to think about summary of the report. So then finally closing of the incident. This is common for the malware investigation process. Okay. These are all very simple and very straightforward now. We can go and we can see. Yeah.
In this also, we have to block the domain and IP address, right?
Yes. If it's a phishing email and it's a malicious one, yes, we have to block those things as well, right? Yeah. So we have to block IP address and domain name also. We have to block domain name and also IP address. So even what level of the data breach it has happened, we have to see using DLP logs. So that is common for every tool. So these are all things are straightforward. Now this is combination of phishing email investigation plus malware investigation, guys. This is combination of phishing email investigation plus malware investigation. So this is very straightforward. First one is phishing email investigation to single user, malicious URL link to single user, malicious malware attachment to single user. Okay, now. So take these three scenarios. So first one is, fourth one. Okay, malicious URL link as a spear phishing. What is spear phishing?
Attack, sending a mail to a group of users.
Yes. Okay, malicious URL link as a spear phishing sent it by an attacker to 10 end users. How can you do investigation? So what is the answer? Just you can apply whatever we discussed. 10 users, what all things you will validate?
IP.
10 users, already we given 10 users hint also, not single user now. So phishing email attacker attached a malicious URL link and he sent it to 10 users.
First, we need to check how many members have clicked on that URL.
Yes. So we have to take care of all these things same as it is. So domain validation, IP address validation, and so on. Additionally, URL validation. So URL you will take and you will check the reputation of the URL later. So how find many users are clicked?
End users.
Yeah, find the end users. Perfect. Find the end users. So find the end users meaning here, how many end users of those 10 users out of maybe 1,000 employees or maybe 10,000 employees? How can you get those information? Find the end users. How can you get these information? How can you get these information? Who are all received the malicious URL link?
By firewall, sir.
Firewall, no.
Sir, SMTP server?
SMTP server or?
Email gateway.
Right. So using subject line or maybe using sender email address. Using subject line or maybe using sender email address, we can filter out. How many end users are clicked on? Subject line you can filter out. Okay, malicious URL link example. Or a gift card or voucher card link. In such a way they will give. So just you can filter out using that gift card or voucher card link or malicious URL link. Then you will come to know how many 10 users are received. Okay, after receiving that one. So next step, what will you do? So based on this,
whether they clicked it or not.
Okay, which tool you will verify whether I clicked or not? We will verify who clicked on
proxy
URL link out of 10 users. How many people are clicked on out of 10 users? Yeah, someone has said answer correct. Who is that? Proxy.
Proxy server.
Yeah, proxy and also
firewall.
Firewall.
Yeah, proxy and firewall we can see. So redirection or packet drop or enable or reset or transmitted. Okay. So out of 10 users, example, maybe 8 users did not click on. Maybe 2 users clicked on. Okay. What will you do? So out of 10 users now. So total number of users is 10. So clicked user is 2. Unclicked user is 8. So next step.
We'll delete the file from the 8 fellows first.
Yes, perfect. So what is this one is called as?
Email
what is this process called? Email purging. That's perfect. So this process deleting of the mails from the respective end user machines is called as email purging. So which tool you will go and you will delete these files? I mean emails. Which tool you will go and you will delete these unclicked users emails?
EDR.
EDR, are you sure? Not yeah. Files here. Mails.
Oh, sorry, emails. Email gateway.
Email gateway or?
SMTP.
Yes. Email purging. So email gateway or SMTP server. We can go and we can delete. So next one, what about these clicked users? Clicked users?
Two contaminate.
Users. Yes, that's correct. So clicked users, we have to follow the containment and so on. So same as it is. Clicked users are 2. So now this process, same as it is. Okay, we have to, first thing is we have to change the password, guys. Outlook or email password we have to change. Why? Because once attacker will gain the email access from his email on behalf of the end user, he will send the malicious URL link to enter organization level. So that's why we have to change the email password is first. Okay. So this is the way how practically they will ask, guys. Today, interview question, just one hour back, this is the interview question. So out of 10 users, 2 users are clicked on the malicious URL link. As a security analyst, first action item, what will you do? First action, what will you do?
remove the email from the unused users. That is okay. Email purging.
Yeah, first we have to identify. So out of 10 users, so 2 users are belongs to clicked users. Remaining 8 users are belongs to unclicked users. Whoever did not click on those users, we have to delete email purging option. And whoever has clicked on, I will go and I will change the immediately password reset or password changing. So that is what we have to do. Just 1 hour back, these are all interview questions. Okay. So now, next scenario is same thing. Phishing email attacker sent an email to 10 users with attaching malware file. How can you do investigation? Instead of URL link, what is the here additional thing? Malware attachment. So next, these are all things you will do. Validation part, same as it is. So out of 10 users now. So additionally, what will you do? Additional validation.
Actually, I have the file.
Okay, first one is what is the file name, file size, hash value validation. Okay, another one, malware validation, we will take care. Using hash value method or file. Okay, using hash value method or file. So we can use sandboxing environment or maybe using hash value itself we can take and we can go to the, where can you take hash value, guys?
EDR tool.
EDR tool, that's correct. So same applicable here, total number of users and downloaded users and undownloaded users. Total number of users are 10 and downloaded users are 2.
Sir.
Yes.
First, we have to find who are the 10 people, right?
Yes, correct. Yeah, that we have to do, right? Not downloaded. Users 8. Yeah, that give me 1 second. Yeah, we have to identify that one also. So find the end users in the SMTP server, nothing but who are all the 10 users. So now additionally, what will you do now? So not downloaded users, what will you do this one?
Delete the malware file.
Yes, delete the mails directly, yeah. Delete the emails for 8 users, whoever did not download. Okay, this called, what is this option is called? Email
purging.
Yeah, email purging. Okay, what about these two now? Downloaded users.
Contaminate,
okay. Containment or network isolation of the downloaded users. Next one.
Name the downloaded file and
yes. Verify the whether that malicious thing is there or not. Next one is delete those files. Delete the files from the end user machines. Next one.
Block the hash value.
Yeah. Block the domain name. And also
IP address.
Next one, rerun the antivirus scans. Change the password for Windows machine as well as email. Yeah. Finally, make a
summary
of the report and close the incident. So nothing but combination of both malware investigation along with this one. So we have phishing email investigation also. So take these type of investigations, guys, and explain in the interview point of view. Okay. So now one more thing. This is combination of both technical plus managerial. Let's see who will give the answer. I'm a little bit fast because all these things we discussed in previous classes. Okay. So 100 phishing email attackers sent 100 phishing emails to 100 different users. 100 phishing email attackers sent 100 phishing emails to 100 different users. How can you do investigation? Anyone?
Sir, first we have to verify that who are the 100 people.
Okay, 100 people you will verify.
From there, we need to segregate the levels.
Okay, first of all, how many attacks here? How many attacks here?
100 into 100. 100 into 100, sir.
No, 100 phishing email attackers sent an email to 100 fish, 100 end users.
You said 100 phishing emails.
Yeah.
Each 100, sir, or one email?
No, 100 only, 100. Total, how many attacks?
100 attacks.
Oh. 100 attacks, right. 100 attacks. 100 different users, 100 attacks. So now, how can you prioritize these incidents?
First, we'll see in this the endpoints. Is there any servers? Those are emails, right?
Yeah, so, email server. Why will receive emails?
No, no, we'll, no, no. We'll yeah. find who are opened it.
Receive that email.
Okay, so we will see who are all received the emails. Okay, but how can you prioritize? 100 attacks are there. How can you prioritize? Which one you will prioritize first?
Based upon severity, sir.
Okay, 100. All severity is 100.
Based on the role basis.
Okay, so someone has said it's perfect answer based on severity. So as interviewer, I'm asking back once again. All 100 users, sir, all 100 phishing emails belongs to critical severity. Then in that scenario, severity is same as it is. If it is different severity, I will agree with you. So based on the critical, high, medium, low, or informational, maybe out of 100, so 10 is belongs to critical, I will prioritize 10 those first one. Maybe 50 is belongs to high, so next one is 50. After that 40, so then medium, we will prioritize. But all severity levels are same, critical.
In this 100, who declined mail link, who downloaded that file, let us segregate them.
By that time, your SLA will cross, right? You are going and you are checking and you are validating. So each and every SLA time is only 4 hours.
As per the business impact to the people.
Yeah, as per the business impact, okay. Yeah, that is also, I'll put it here, as per the business impact.
Means a particular department system got hacked, it is a business impact, then we'll take the priority for that first.
But even for as per the business impact also, so you can go and after opening the email, then only will come to know what, which business it is belongs to, whether, so server is this, first of all, server will not be there, whether maybe senior level of the directors or board of directors or senior managers or higher level people is available. So that validation also, it will take some time. Don't you think it will take some time?
Yeah, it will take SLA and cross.
Yes.
So first, we need to block the IP addresses from when we got these mails.
We'll block all those emails. If it is legitimate and business emails?
This net phishing email.
Without validating, how can you block phishing emails? Without validating and checking the investigation, how can you say that it is not a phishing email? It's a phishing email, sorry. Without validating and without investigating, will you go and block the phishing emails? By concluding that, yes, it is a phishing email, I am blocking all those 100 phishing emails.
Any clues, sir, from which area?
This is managerial question, guys.
I think we have to give you a circular that no one has to open the mails.
So that okay. If that is awareness, you will give, okay? That is okay, fine. Awareness is one thing. Any other?
Sir, what is the question? I didn't come across.
So in this scenario, 100 attacks came, 100 phishing emails are there in the queue. So nothing but all our severity is a critical. Okay. So now, which one you will prioritize first? That is the question. Or how can you handle this particular situation? How can you handle? So what are technical things you said? That's perfectly all right. Think about managerial point of view also. Process point of view.
We are discuss with team members and...
Excellent. Sudha, excellent, Sudha. Perfect answer. So we have to discuss with our team members, guys. Why you are not thinking about team coordination, supporting each other, helping each other? Do you think that you are alone is there in the shift? So these are all managerial questions. So one is a technical point of view, whatever you said, that's correct. Based on the severity, that is correct. And based on, once again, I said 100 phishing emails. Why don't you say based on in time? Based on in time also, first in, first out. When you say first in, first out, whatever attack is coming, as example, 7 o'clock. That is the first email came to me in our queue. So that one, it has to go out. So that is maybe also wrong. Why? Because whatever that particular end users are there, couple of people are belongs to veiling kind of thing, senior board of directors or senior managers or CISO, CEO, CTO, CFO. In this scenario, so obviously we cannot handle single person. So we have to discuss with our team members. So many attacks are there, so many phishing email has come. You can do 10 email investigations. I will do 10 email investigations. Someone else do 10 email investigations, sharing each other, supporting each other, coordinating each other. Still you are facing some of the issues and you are not able to complete. What will you do? What will you do? So here team support and team coordination and speaking with other team members. Okay, so even though, okay, 4 members are there in the respective, so team now, that particular shift maybe. So everyone has taken 10. So 4 into 10, how many? 40. Only you completed 40 with the help of team members. Remaining 60? What will you do in that scenario?
We will request entire team members to work on this.
Okay, so what is that process is called as? We have to follow on process. What is that process is called as?
Escalation.
Excellent. Escalation matrix. We have to follow escalation matrix. It is not in our hands. So escalation matrix we have to follow. What is mean by escalation matrix? It is not in our hands. Okay, we are not able to complete all those. Then we have to inform to L2, L2 team will inform to L3, L3 team will inform to SOC manager, SOC manager will inform to director, director will inform to CISO. So these many things are there. Maybe whoever is working on second shift, those people also will come now. Whoever is working on third shift, those people also, they will request SOC manager, please go and do work this one. Then we will provide the allowances to you because you are doing additional work beyond your so normal shifting timings. So this is completely not at all technical, guys. It's a process based or a managerial based question. Whether you are aware of the escalation matrix, whether you are mingling with other team members or not, whether you will support with other team members, you will take care of the help from other team members. Okay, so whether you're following escalation matrix. So this is nothing but process-oriented question. This is what I told you. In the second round of the interview, we will expect these type of questions only. Okay. So technical, whatever you said, absolutely right. I don't say that it's wrong. Okay, so this is also process-oriented questions also you should, you have to follow. So one more question I will give. I mean, managerial based question. One of the unknown scenario came to you in SIM tool that is not at all existing in our SOP or playbooks or run books. Your alone is there in this shift. What will you do? I'm repeating once again. In Pongal time or in Christmas time, in Ramadan time, okay, only your alone is there in this shift. Unfortunately, one of the unknown scenario, it has come to as an alert notification. Okay, what will you do in that particular scenario?
How can you handle the situation?
I'm sorry?
SOC manager is also not there?
Yes, SOC manager also not there.
Then vendor.
Vendor directly? Wrong answer.
From senior members, we can...
Senior members, wrong answer.
Discuss with manager.
Discuss with wrong answer.
We do have some help desk in the tool.
Wrong answer. Yeah, all these are you are saying second, third, fourth, fifth.
Sir, first we have to check and then we have to give some analysis what we have done and what is the beyond that our analysis is the...
What is that process is called as? So nowadays, not nowadays, sorry guys, this is called self-learning skills. So will you do alone yourself? Okay, so nothing but you have interest is there to learn about new things or not. Eagerly learn new things. What you have to do? Myself, I will take care of the R&D. Is there any knowledge base is available? Is there any resources is available? I will go to Google and I will identify. I'll go to YouTube and I will do it. Still, I'm not able to identify what to do, how to do, and when to do, and so on. In that scenario, whatever you said, that's correct. I'll contact my senior members, team members. I'll contact SOC manager and so on. So what is the main aim for this particular answer? So answer whether you are learning to new things or not. Self-learning capability, you are thinking or not. Your personality development skills, guys, this one.
Sir?
Yes.
Sorry to say this. If it is unknown, obviously it will compromise the system.
So if it is unknown, first at least, so 4 hours SLA is there. 10 minutes, don't go and spend time with on all these things, Google or YouTube or maybe some other things. Okay. Before going and reaching directly to the SOC manager.
Yes, sir. I forgot SLA. Perfect. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is what is the main intention of this particular question is. So self-learning, self-capability. So do you aware of the knowledge base? Do you aware of the standard operating process documents? Do you aware of the YouTube and Google and other websites or blogs? So indirectly, it's a training and development and self-learning skills. So this is also one of the popular interview question, guys. Especially second round of the interview, almost these questions. Whenever you are attending the calls with the second round of the calls with the North America, South America, Middle East, Europe, customers or clients, you'll face these type of interview questions only. How can you handle this particular situation? Okay, so this is not about technical. So it's a process oriented and your personality development and self-learning and eager to learn new things. Okay. So that is about how to answer these type of questions, guys. Is it clear or not? We'll discuss. These are all the couple of questions are there, especially for the managerial round and director round. So this is the way they will ask. So what are the different websites you will follow? Where do you want to see yourself after 5 years or after 10 years? Okay. How can you manage up to date what's happening all over the worldwide or across the universe? What will do it? Is there certifications are mandatory to learn or to do for business point of view? Okay. So these are all completely managerial based questions they will ask in the interview point of view. So first round you are clearing almost interview is over, guys. So second round is a combination of little bit technical, remaining 50% is managerial based and also process oriented questions. Per day, how many incidents you will do? How many members team is there? Okay, so what is shift rotation? What is shift tracking? What is it mean by handover? Will you coordinate with, will you communicate with the customer or clients? Do you have global exposure, is there or not? Okay, so this is what they will expect. Okay, so this question, okay, so it's one combination of both the technical as well as managerial. In the pressurized condition, how can you handle the situation? Okay, so this is nothing but one type of managerial based question. Even I told you yesterday, I think day before yesterday, 100 servers are got compromised. What will you do? So this is also one type of technical plus managerial based question. Technical plus managerial based question. We will go and we'll see whether lateral movement has happened. So whether it's coming through phishing email, okay, malware attachment. And also, so I will validate one server, my colleague is validate one server, my another colleague is validated one server. So based on these three analysis within 30 to 1 hour time period, so whether that particular server is got compromised through malware or maybe through credential scuffing or maybe through DOS or DDoS, I will identify and we can make a summary of the report. So it's a combination of both technical plus, so process oriented and team oriented and supporting team each other. Okay. So that's all about oral phishing email investigation, guys. So this is also one of the favorite interview questions. Okay. Today interview, almost they are concentrated only this one, whatever we discussed, 15 to 20 minutes. Okay. So that is about phishing email investigation. And also a couple of other EDR related questions they asked. What is EDR implementation or design? Anyone? What is EDR implementation or design?
Configuring the policies.
EDR design architecture. EDR architecture. EDR architecture. What is EDR architecture or design or deployment?
Servers are connected.
Server to client.
Server and client. What is mean by that one?
I'll install the main EDR in my main server and agents in all the endpoints.
Okay.
Then I'll start monitoring all the agents from the single server.
Okay. So will you open the port or not? Will you open the port or not?
Yes.
Yes, we have to open the port for communication side, agent to server communication, EDR tool.
HTTPs.
Yes. So we have to open the port as well. Most of the cases 443 or 8443. What is the difference between legacy antivirus and next generation antivirus? Can you explain one or two features? Legacy antivirus.
In legacy antivirus, it cannot perform all DLP, HAPS, and one more things. But EDR can do all the things like DLP, HAPS individually.
Even a couple of legacy antivirus tools also will do basic of DLP and also file integrity monitoring. But main feature.
EDRs have the threat intelligence needs.
Okay.
Feeds inside. Inbuilt.
Perfect. Yes, any other? That's perfect answer.
And it
any
generates
other?
The hash value internally.
Yes, perfect.
And allows us to block the.
Yeah, so affected. But main features.
EDR tools, software.
In the next generation firewall, we can do Wi-Fi monitoring.
Next generation firewall, why are you bringing firewall topic now? What is the question I asked, Naomi?
It has a limited.
Limited production.
Limited production.
And
difference between legacy antivirus and also next generation antivirus.
EDR is SaaS based, sir.
Okay, EDR is SaaS based nowadays. Okay.
That is also not the main answer, sir.
No, that is also not main answer. So I will give the answer now. So main thing is MITRE framework is not integrated to legacy antivirus server. So whatever tactics attacker is using, techniques attacker is using, and also what are the mitigation steps and procedures. So that is not available in the traditional antivirus or legacy antivirus. So second point is, as you said, that's correct. Threat intelligence feeds integration regularly, whatever it is happening all over the worldwide. That's correct answer. Third one is, anyone? Third one. Integration with the third party tools. Example, virustotal.com. Who's the domain? Okay. Next one is hybridanalysis.com. That particular analysis is not there in the so legacy antivirus or a traditional antivirus. One more. Machine learning capability, deep learning capability, artificial intelligence. Detection methods, it's not existing in traditional antivirus or legacy antivirus. Yeah. So these are all the four features. MITRE framework, threat intelligence feeds integration. Okay, next one is third party open source tools integration. Fourth one is machine learning and behavioral analytics part. So that is the difference. Okay. So do you know what? How much they offered for this candidate? 29 lakhs. Package. It's a design and implementation. What is IBM QRadar architecture? What is IBM QRadar architecture?
Three components.
What are those three components?
Log collector, log manager, log processor, and user console.
Are you sure? IBM QRadar, not generic architecture diagram.
IBM QRadar.
Log collector, flow collector, sir. Log collector, flow collector.
Log collector, flow collector?
Event processor and event collector.
Tell in the proper way. Are you saying top to bottom or bottom to top?
Event processor.
Event processor is middle.
Curator console.
Curator console, okay.
Indexing, querying, filtering.
No. Components.
Event procedure.
Sir, can I?
Yes,
from bottom to top. From bottom to top, collector. Sir. Event or flow collector.
Okay.
Event or flow processor.
Okay.
With node for a separate extra storage memory. Perfect. And QRadar console.
Excellent. This is the answer, guys. So when you are saying about the architecture diagram, you have to say from top to bottom or bottom to top also. He has to understand, right? Are you saying from top to bottom or bottom to top? What is the difference between normalization and parsing? What is the difference between normalization and parsing?
In the normalization, we get raw logs, whereas in the parsing, it is understandable log format.
That is also, even in the normalization, parsing also will get normal raw logs.
In normalization, we compress the data into 1:10 ratio.
Okay.
And it will be in a raw format. And later, the normalization, we do parsing to convert into the understandable log event format.
So what is that format name is called as?
SIM2.
Event.
Format name.
Yeah. Format name only, sir. Leaf in QRadar.
In QRadar, generic way?
Common.
Yeah, common.
Common event format.
Yes.
Yeah. Common event format.
Common event format. So these are all the interview questions, guys. Okay. Yeah. Anyway, we can discuss a couple of other things as well. I'm gathering all these interview questions. Yeah, that's all for today. So what I will do tomorrow, we can discuss about, can you go and can you take care of these investigations as well? I will give some of the hints. Then I will rectify tomorrow morning and tomorrow evening. DOS and DDoS attack. So DOS and DDoS attack. Okay, so log sources are, you know already, firewall is one of the log source. Why firewall is the log source? Anyone? For DOS and DDoS attack, why firewall is log source? How firewall is a log source?
Flooding is one reason for DOS and DDoS, sir.
Yes, correct. Flooding is the reason. So many requests. So why firewall is log source? Yeah.
Because the denial of service will occur only from firewall majorly.
Yeah, so reason is we are creating DOS policy in firewall. Unless entire inbound traffic and outbound traffic is traversing through firewall. And also we are defining throttling as well. We have seen FortiGate firewall DOS policy creation for outbound interface. That is nothing but WAN interface. So that's a firewall. You know, inbound traffic and outbound traffic will be monitored by firewall. That's a firewall is one of the log source. Abnormal behavior, suspicious behavior, or baseline crossing is a part of IDS IPS. So obviously anti-DOS and anti-DDoS tools in parallel to which router? Anti-DOS and anti-DDoS tools in parallel to which router?
ISP.
ISP router. Okay. And WAF, even DOS and DDoS attacks applicable to application as well. Example, consider youtube.com. Maybe couple of times too much of the flooding of the request will come. So what we can see at the time of playing the video, we can see buffer. So if attacker is doing the same thing, he is completely targeting the YouTube server. So when flooding of the request will come and buffer will happen, finally that YouTube server itself, it will get damaged or crashed. So even DOS and DDoS is applicable to WAF also. Finally, backend server. So server, normally attacker main recon or weaponization, recognition, selection of the target. Selection of the target is obviously server or application. Okay, in server logs also, it's very important. The throttling we'll do on the server side as well. So that's why these are all the different types of log sources. DLP also very important. In case any data breach has happened, we have to verify. Now, once DOS and DDoS attack will come to the server, what exactly you will do the investigation? Take a server and you can write the analysis. Similar to like whatever you have done for the ransomware attack. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So false positive and true positive, both you can write. False positive and true positive. Okay, next, why I'm giving the okay assignment to you, you are practicing and you are thinking the logical way. So if I will rectify tomorrow, after going to the interview, it is very easy for you. There is no need to byhat anything. There is no need to mug up anything. Okay. That's why I'm giving all these assignment to you. Please think in positive way. So next one is one of the system is got compromised and keep on contacting or communicating to command and control server. So most of the case, this use case is belongs to IDS IPS. IDS IPS. One of the end user system or server got compromised already. So take one of the end user system as a laptop and also take one of the system as server. Already got compromised. There is no false positive, only true positive, right? Already got compromised means false positive or true positive?
True positive.
In that scenario, how can you handle the situation? Total end-to-end, containment, eradication, mitigations, lessons learned, everything you have to do. Forget about false positive now. Already in the use case, it is showing that one of the system got compromised. When you say system here, I'll put both. So laptop or server. Already this use case is already completed. Okay, now you have to do the analysis now. So please go through this one as well. So next one, SQL injection attack, I'll explain tomorrow. SQL injection, I will explain. Okay, SQL injection, cross-site scripting, almost all those different types of attacks will fall under same category. Which category is that one?
Where? SQL.
Yeah. What is the category?
Application.
What is that name? Which category of the attacks? Application only. What is the category of the attacks case? SQL injection, cross-site scripting, broken authentication, broken access control.
OWASP top 10.
Perfect. OWASP top 10. OWASP top 10. Okay. So you have to remember that one also. Okay, guys, that's all. And whoever shared ransomware attack, I will go through that particular documentation and we can discuss that one also tomorrow. Okay. So tomorrow morning, I'll explain SQL injection attack. tomorrow evening, once you will complete DOS and DDoS, and one of the end user system, laptop or server is got compromised, and keep on communicating command and control server. Those two things we can discuss evening. Then tomorrow evening, we can start the interview questions also if time permits. Okay, so that's all for today. So as I said, whatever you like and whatever you are very much confident. Okay, when you are explaining the scenario, you can take one or two scenarios. Those two scenarios you can explain for every interview. Okay, your choice. We have more than 10 are there. So whatever you like, your choice, your option. But don't take in simple, simple incident investigation, take complicated and complex or difficult. Okay, better you can take server related things. That is my opinion. Okay, guys, that's all for today, guys. Do you have any questions? Okay, tomorrow morning class is there at 8:00. Good night.
Good night, sir.
Good night.
Good night, sir.